Christ is fine. So he'll open, then we're going to. We're going to watch the lady.
Good morning.
Not you.
Good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Would you stand with us this morning as we lift up the Lord in prayer and praise? You know, on my way to church this morning, I was praying and driving. But when I woke up this morning and the Lord opened my eyes and I saw the joy of a new day, I said, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me hear some amen. Amen.
Y'all, come on, let's join in. We're going old school this morning. Well, I woke up this morning with my mind scared.
Psalms 71, 17 through 21. It says, since my youth, O God, you have taught me, and to this day I declare your marvelous deeds. Even when I am old and gray, do not forsake me, O God, until I declare your power to the next generation, your might to all who are to come. Your righteousness reaches to the skies, O God. You who have done great things, who, O God, is like you. Though you have made me see troubles and many and bitter, you will restore my life again. From the depths of the earth, you will again bring me up. You will increase my honor and comfort me once again. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of his word.
Amen. Dear Lord, we just come this morning with humble hearts. We stand in your sanctuary. Lord, we just pray that you would touch each and every one that came through those doors this morning. Lord, and if it was anything like sin, we ask you to remove it right now. Because we come to serve and worship you and you alone. No matter what we have gone through this past week, no matter what had happened last night, we just pray, Lord, that you keep us as we go through this day. Now, dear Lord, we bless each and every one who's standing and sitting in these pews this morning. We pray a special prayer and a special blessing, Lord. We pray that you touch their heart, mind, soul, and spirit, that they might reach out and call out your name. Yeah. Whatever they're going through, ask them just to give you strength. Yeah. Lord, we are weak. We are weak, but you are yet strong. So if we just reach out and call upon your name, we pray for those who had a desire to get up and couldn't get out for whatever reason, we pray a blessing over them. We pray for every hospital, every nursing home, every school, every college. Lord, so much happening in this world. We just pray for the police force. Lord, we pray that that you would move in a mighty way in their heart, mind, soul, and spirit, and that we get it right. For our little children going to school, don't want to go to school because of tragedy. People are shooting young folks everywhere, Lord. It's a sin, and I know you're not pleased with it. And we just have to call upon you and give you the praise and the honor. And Lord, we thank you for this pastor who leads this flock. Yes. We pray that you continue to give him wisdom and knowledge to carry out what you have placed him to do. And Lord, we pray that we be receptive to whatever he bring across the pulpit, that it will touch our heart, mind, soul, make us better people as we walk through this dangerous world, Lord. Thank you. We lift you up, we magnify, we edify, we glorify your name. We give you all the honor and the praise. And those that who love the Lord say, amen.
Now join us in singing Leaning on the Everlasting Arm, hymn number 262. What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arm.
You may be seated. Good morning again.
Good morning.
I am here to welcome you to the Golden Gate Missionary Baptist Church, where Minister Vincent T. Parker is the pastor. We welcome each and every one of you. We are glad that you came. And we hope you feel the same. This welcome comes from our hearts. So, as you go about from place to place, if for good preaching and singing you search, to find that, be sure to come by Golden Gate. Because you are certainly welcome. Why are we here today? Why are we here today? I would like for each of you to take a minute to look over at the center aisle. If you have ever been to a circus, the focus is always on the center aisle. And it takes hard work and time to get there. Sometimes we as seniors wake up and we don't know what day it is. So today is Silver Eagle Day, a special day, Sunday, September the 11th, 2022. A historical day in the life of seniors at the Golden Gate Missionary Baptist Church, where we recognize some outstanding seniors who have stood the test of time. Somewhat like an old copper pot that is seasoned by fire, dinged up, but still shine. Life brings us many golden moments which we treasure. Today is such an occasion. We shall look back to this occasion with pleasure, and it will be a cherished memory. The love and fellowship generated today will be a monument that age cannot destroy, nor time erase. The eagle is flying today because it chose to move on. Thank you.
Good morning again. This is our memorial period. During our memorial week, we came to honor some of the seniors that have gone on before us. They've gone on to be with the Lord. Thank you. And also, we're gonna honor some of the seniors that went on, say, in 2020. And we're gonna look on the screen. I'm gonna ask you to pay attention to the screen. And we're gonna view some of the seniors that left here in 2020 up until today. And I would like to ask you to pray for the bereaved families of these seniors that you're gonna see on today, you're going to see their pictures, you're going to recognize them. So pay attention to the screens. Amen.
Amen,
amen, and thank you.
Worship today. It is great to be alive. It is great to, for Sister Hill to remind us what day it is. I don't know if you caught that in her occasion today. She said some seniors sometimes don't know what day it is, so she listed all. I said, well, thank you, Sister. Today we celebrate our seniors, our silver eagles in the life of this church and ministry. Let's give them a big hand this morning. We started with our old school devotion, and we are here to let our seniors know that we stand on their shoulders. We sit in a building that other folk built and paid for. We have lights because somebody else sacrificed. We are here in this place. I don't know about you, but I'm standing on some folks' prayers that are no longer here. I'm living off of their prayers, and I'm grateful today as we take this day on second Sunday in September every year for these last 20-some years to celebrate our seniors in the life of our church. And today, we honor four persons who will receive the Silver Eagle Award. We usually do our award on a luncheon on Saturday, the day before. But because of COVID, we have not done it until today. We wanted to ease our way back into this, and so we're sharing what we usually do on Saturday at our luncheon. We want to present our Silver Eagle Award this year to these four honorees. I want to thank God for our. I'm looking at some of my mothers I haven't seen or don't get to see too often. Give our mothers board a big hand. Yeah, we got a mother's board. I love it. I love it. I always say I got the best dressed mothers anywhere. I got the best mothers anywhere. I'm telling you. Hey, let me tell you. We thank God for them, all our seniors, many of who are sitting in the center here. And amen. I'm going to meet with the committee right after this worship service, because y'all got all this blue and silver on, and I'm starting to feel some kind of way about it. I just am. I couldn't let it go. I'm just feeling some kind of way about that thing. I don't know what you're trying to say, but we're going to fix it. And Sister Parker says she's praying for me. I'm going to do something off script for a moment, because I got the mic and they tell me I'm still the pastor. Those of you who turned 70 since this time last year, would you stand? If you're not ashamed, you turned 70 since we last. Oh, yeah. A couple of y'all here. There we go. Amen. Okay. As you get you guys get your silver eagle pin, because you turn 70, you get a silver eagle pin. And so we want to make sure you get that. All three of you who are here, and we've got this one here for the brothers. Now, the sisters get this big old pretty pin. The brothers get a little lapel pin. This was nice. All right? So we're going to make sure you get your pin. And the mother's board, we got some new mothers that we'll be presenting next first Sunday. We got some new mothers on our mother's board, and they get this huge pin. Amen. And so we look forward to that. But today we want to present me and Pastor Ron Bisbins. Would you come up here, brother? Come on. I say Pastor Ron Bisbins because since we last, in the last 2-3 months, he has been called to the Mount Zion Baptist Church, Sand Branch, Texas. He and his wife, he has Minister Bisbins. Now, Pastor Bisbins has been serving as our seniors ministry leader. How many years now? I forgot now. Let's not add it up. But he has been faithfully serving interim at the Mount Zion Church in Sand Branch, especially through this COVID period. And I just want to take this time from the church to tell you thank you for your ministry and your service here. And all the work that you and your wife have done and are doing in the life of this church. And the members of Sand Branch that are here, would you stand? Come on, let's give them a big hand, Golden Gate. Amen. We are so glad that you are sharing and worship with us today. Now, let me warn you, you got a loud pastor. Y'all done figured it out already. You done figured it out. You got a loud pastor. And he be loud at the strangest times, too. See, they already know you, man. And guess what? We done put up with him, and we love him, but we sending him to you. This brother loves the Lord, and I don't know a more generous, serving preacher than Ron Bisbins. To a fault, to a sacrifice, to where he'll go without his stuff in order to serve. And so, brother, we have seen that in you. We congratulate you. And whatever, this brother sends me a text every morning, every Sunday morning, praying. This brother, now I don't know what and I know he does that with other pastors as well. Every Sunday morning, there's going to be a text from Ron Bisbins saying, I'm praying for you, Pastor. I'm praying. Not only does he do stuff under the table, behind the scenes, where nobody can see, like that prayer, but all the people's servant, as he's known as. And so, I'm glad that you're here today to help us present these Silver Eagle Award, but since this is your swan song, I guess, because you got responsibilities now beyond the Golden Gate Church. Whatever you have been here and whatever you have done here, may it come back to you sevenfold. Hallelujah. As you serve, brother. All right? Bless you. Bless you. Now, we got four of our members here who have served in the life of the church. In order to be receive the what they call now the prestigious Silver Eagle Award in the life of this church, first off, you got to have an age requirement. You got to be 75, all right? So if you're shaming your age, then you ain't going to get the reward because it ain't going to come your way. So they aging themselves just by stepping up here and their willingness to receive this award. There, some relevant information is in the bulletin of each in the program here today. I could tell you a story about each and every one of them just as their pastor. And I'm not going to do that, but I just want you to read that bio. But not only do you have to be 75, you have served for 20, 25 years or more in the life of this church and have served well. Now, the preachers don't get this. Every now and then they do, but we wanted to honor the people that don't get honored and recognized, the people who do stuff that you never see, the people who serve quietly, and some of them are publicly. One of them's the elder, one of them's a deacon, but they serve publicly. There's other, but the work that they do to build the foundation of this church and the ministry here is unseen by their prayers, by their faithfulness, by their sacrifice. See, folk like this come and do when nobody else will. Folk like this will show up when the crowd is low, when there's no crowd, and because they're not tied to the crowd, they're tied to the Lord and serving Him. These persons in the life of this church have done that. And they've done it for at least 25 years. As I look at this list, all of them, a couple of them have been here before the carpet was laid, as I say. they've served faithfully under Reverend Smith, and they've served faithfully under me, and I thank God for each of them. As a pastor, I appreciate their, I know that these folk pray for me, because they fuss at me. Only one of them don't fuss at me. She just be so sweet and just look at me and say, I'm praying for you, Pastor. But those are the kind of people that we seek to honor with this Silver Eagle Award. And so, as you see in your program, we're going in alphabetical order. Our first Silver Eagle Awardee for 2022 is Elder Tommy Bowie. Come on. Amen. This is my elder, my deacon, and my friend. Congratulations on all your work and service here at the Golden Gate Church. Our next is my seat buddy. When I came to the Golden Gate Church, I sat right there where Sister Hill is sitting. And Joe Helen Frazier was the announcement clerk. Until Reverend Smith made me move up into the pulpit, I sat next to her for 7-8 years, and she nudged me and said, wake up. Sister Jo Helen Frazier. The next person is she's one of the first of three in the life and history of this church. I had to say something about each one of them. We've never had a female deacon in the life of this church. And just before COVID hit in 2020, we ordained 3 women as deacons here in this church. And each one of them had to be persons that the congregation would recognize, that they're leaders in the life of this church. And I must say about Sister Ruthie Sellers, now Deacon Ruthie Sellers, there was no way, and I told her this, there's no way you can turn me down. We can't have one of the first female deacons and it not be you. And she graciously consented. Deacon Ruthie Sellers. Last person is one of the most quietest, and I don't even know how to describe this woman's tremendous influence in the life of this church without saying 5 words. She has served faithfully her family, her husband, this church, the seniors ministry, along with, we wanted to give, when we gave Deacon Session the Silver Eagle Award a couple of years ago, we wanted to give one to her. They were both stepping aside from seniors ministry, but she wasn't old enough. And we told Deacon Session, you robbed the cradle. See, we tried to. But this year, we are pleased and honored to share the 2022 Silver Eagle Award with Deaconess Georgette Session. Amen. Let's give them all a huge hand. Come on, let's stand. Okay. Amen. You may be seated. We're going to do something special. Y'all stand right here. Stay right one more second. I forgot to do this. You hear family members of Brother Tommy Bowie, those that will claim him as a... Would you stand? His son. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Family members of Sister Jo Helen Frazier. I was about to say, y'all may as well stand because they cousins. So you can't. Don't be careful who you talk about here at the Golden Gate Church. You don't know who's who. Amen. You may be seated. Deaconess Ruthie Sellers, family and friends, stand. Amen.